If you are looking to light up that date night or just have a good time with all your loved ones, I have just the recipe for you. Hi guys, this is snehal.vaidya and welcome back to the Paleo Palette Cafe. Today we're going to be making my most decadent, creamy and lovely three-layered raspberry cheesecake. It's made with all natural ingredients and is completely 100% paleo compliant. And with a few tweaks, it can be made vegan as well. Also, it tastes absolutely heavenly. So let's get to making it.
I'm going to start by adding 1 3/4 cups of almond flour to a blender. To this, I'm going to add 1/4 cup of pure desi ghee. And if you want to keep it completely vegan, add in coconut oil instead. Then I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of Himalayan sea salt and about 8 to 9 pitted medjool dates. Then I'm going to run them through a blender to form a coarse paste. And halfway through the blending, you might want to check on the batter and scrape down the sides. At this point of time, I'm also going to add 1/2 cup of pecan nuts to this. And then I'm going to blend everything together to form a nice coarse paste. Next, I'm going to grease a 9-inch baking dish with coconut oil and empty the batter on this dish. Then I'm going to use my hands to flatten the batter against the baking dish in order to spread it evenly. And once that is done, I'm going to cover this with a clean cloth and keep it in the fridge until we prepare the rest of the ingredients. Next, we'll prepare the sauce. To a heated skillet on a medium flame, I'm going to add 2 1/2 cups of fresh or frozen raspberries. To this, I'm going to add 4 tablespoons of maple syrup, and you can also use raw honey if you have that at hand. Then I'm going to squeeze in the juice of 1/2 lemon into this. And I'm going to mix them together and cook them, stirring frequently until the mixture comes to a simmer. Then I'm going to turn the heat to a medium high and cook them for about 4 to 5 minutes until the sauce has thickened nicely. And once I have a nice and thick mixture, I'm going to turn off the gas, take an empty bowl and run the mixture through a fine mesh sieve. Then I'm going to use a spatula or a spoon to press out as much raspberry sauce that I can out of the mixture. Also, be sure to scrape the underside of the sieve as that stores a lot of sauce. You can use a spatula, a spoon or anything that you may, deem fit to make sure that you've squeezed out as much sauce out of the mixture as possible. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in 1 tablespoon of seeds back to the sauce. It just helps a lot with the texture and aftertaste, I've noticed. Then I'm going to discard the rest of the seeds. I'm going to cover this bowl and I'm going to keep it in the fridge until we prepare the middle layer. Then I'm going to add 2 cups of cashews to a blender and I've soaked them overnight. To this, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1/2 cup of almond milk plus 1 tablespoon of water, 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar, and 1/2 cup of coconut cream. I'm going to blend them together until they form a creamy paste for me. Halfway through the blending process, I'm going to check on them, scrape off the sides. At this point of time, I'm also going to add in 6 tablespoons of maple syrup to our mixture. And then I'm going to blend all of them together until they form a nice, creamy, thick mixture for me. Somewhat that looks like this. Then I'm going to turn my attention to the almond and dates mixture that has been sitting into the fridge all this while. It must be nice and settled by now. We're going to pour in the cashew batter that we just prepared onto this. And this will form our layer number 2. I'm going to use a spoon or a spatula to even out the layer across the dish. And guys, this layer is incredibly thick and, you know, so beautiful. You got to make it yourself to know what I'm talking about. This is absolutely incredible. Once layer number two has been lined, we're going to line in layer number three, that is our raspberry sauce. I'm going to spread this too using a spatula evenly and extremely gently this time. And once all our three layers have been lined on top of each other, I'm going to take a silver foil and I'm going to cover this dish and I'm going to put it in the freezer to chill overnight, or at least for 6 hours. After sitting in the freezer overnight, this is how it should look. And look at that cake, guys, and look at that blood red color. It's absolutely incredible. It's nice and firm at this point of time. And you know, you'll have to let this sit outside for about 15-20 minutes, you know, before we can start digging in. And a fun way to serve this cake is by cutting it through in various shapes and sizes. Here I have an example to show you. I've carved out a big round shape out of the cake, and if you're feeling fancy, you can decorate the cake with fresh berries, mint leaves, sunflower seeds, cashews, and the options are absolutely endless. Let's have a look at our cake. I'm going to try and cut it through. It's been about 15-20 minutes. I'm going to make a small incision first with the help of, you know, the biggest knife that I have. It's still quite hard, but at this point of time, we should still be able to, you know, achieve this. And I'm going to work my way through the incision and, you know, all the way down. And usually getting the first piece out is a little difficult, but, you know, the subsequent pieces are quite easy. Have a look at the cake, you know, have a look at the lovely three layers. They're nice and firm and, you know, absolutely incredible. And the best way to enjoy this dessert is not with forks and spoons. You gotta take this beauty and dump it in your mouth as a whole, you know. Oh my god. I'm speechless. This is sensational. Can't stop licking my fingers. I hope you guys liked this video, and if you did, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Also, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you make this at home, don't forget to take a picture and tag me on Instagram. I'd love to see your work on my timeline. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.